From baseball
to cheer, we've got the scoop. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Ready? Begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Centurions. Welcome back to the second day of the week. I'm Marcos, and today is Tuesday, March 19th, 2019.
Buenos dias, I'm Victor G, and we welcome you to another Inside Scoop broadcast.
These past 2 weeks, we have been recognizing individual women in respect to Women's History Month.
Quoted, "How important it is for us to recognize and celebrate our heroes and sheroes." A quote from Maya Angelou.
She was a famous American poet and a civil rights activist. Remember that women are recognized for their work in society, and that women are not below anyone, as everyone is equal no matter their gender, race, or religion.
One of the, you know, Marcos, one of the things I hate is taking tests, especially long ones.
What do you mean, like, long ones?
Like, at long one test. Point in your life, you're going to take, like, a long test, like an SAT test, writing test, or even an AP test.
Well, some bad news for you, Victor, but great news for the junior class. Juniors, do you guys know how you should start planning for college? Have any of you guys signed up for the SAT? That will take place on Saturday, May 4th. If you haven't, then what are you guys waiting for? The Higher Education Center is open during your lunch for the rest of this week, March 19th through the 22nd, to help you sign up for the SAT. This is a test you must take in order to apply to a four-year college.
Well, you know, glad I'm not taking that test. Another new seniors who wish on possibly being the 2018 to 2019 Master Century, listen up. Tomorrow in Mrs. Yeager's room, Room 5115, right after school, there will be an informational meeting to where you can get all the details and applications for competing for the Mr. Century title. The grand prize will be one prom ticket and grad bash ticket, as well as a tux rental. Sounds legit, doesn't it? So head on over to Ms. Yeager's room tomorrow.
Moving on with sports, we have a video from Jennifer Gomez, who went out and recorded on Saturday, where the varsity baseball team headed out to Saddleback High School for a heated baseball game.
Good morning, Centurions. I'm Jennifer, and I'm here reporting from Saddleback High School. We're going to be watching our baseball boys play against them.
Good boy.
Hi, reporting live from Saddleback High School. Yes, today's game was very good. We won 20-0. You know, our pitchers went out there, threw strikes, our hitters got hits, and we scored everybody in.
Our current record is 9-2 overall, and then in league we're undefeated, 6-0.
Oh, I remember we used to, like, back then in Kennedy, come out for... Twice this week.
Our next game is against Anaheim at 7 at Glover Stadium. So come on.
the Centurion baseball team came ahead of Saddleback, winning with a score of 15-0.
Congrats to the boys. They are still first place league champs, and we wish them the best for them throughout the rest of the season.
Hopefully they don't get, you know, a bit too dramatic.
I doubt that. You know, they're great individuals. But talking about drama will be having their play called I Hate Shakespeare. This drama event will be starting tomorrow, March 20th through the 22nd at 7 p.m. at night. Ticket prices are $5 pre-sale and $8 at the door. You could purchase tickets this week at the TCC. Here's a drama productions trailer for the upcoming play.
Hate Shakespeare.
That's right, I said it.
No,
I do. I hate Shakespeare.
Why?
I just don't get it. How a mediocre actor from a measly little town is suddenly the brightest jewel.
Get off, whatever your song. I'm afraid the party's over.
My husband seems to have suddenly become a deranged lunatic.
How can you say that? How can you say that?
It's easy, I can say it, cause it's absolutely true. Is he fooling all of you?
But he's proof of what majesty flows from his pen. His poetry soars like a sweet violin. God's own inspiration, like lightning, doth strike him. And he captures my soul.
Ah, jeez, you sound just like him.
You should hate Shakespeare.
Well, I don't. I try to emulate Shakespeare.
Well, there's your problem. You're so blinded by the bard who's such a pompous little man.
Why is it a problem to admit that I'm a fan?
Cause he's a hack with a knack for stealing anything he can.
How can you say that? How can you say that the man really knows how to write a bitch and play?
Splinter. I'm afraid that you can't kill me. No one born of woman can kill me.
Well, I wasn't born a woman. My mother had me by C-section.
Every little thing about Shakespeare is what I
hate. He hates. He clearly, surely, really, truly hates Shakespeare.
Attention, Austin Trains. Are you interested in joining the cheer team? Do you want to cheer on at football games, school events, and overall just be more involved as entry? The opportunity has now come. Here's a short video from the cheer team.
Listen up, y'all, cause this is it. The beat that I'm banging is delicious.
Burgalicious definition, make them boys go loco. They want my treasures so they get their pleasures from my boats. So you can see me, you can't squeeze me. I ain't easy, I ain't sleazy. I got reasons why I tease them. Boys just come and go like seasons. Burgalicious,
so delicious.
But I ain't promiscuous. And if you were suspicious, all that is fictitious. Pablo kisses. That puts them boys on rock, rock. And they be lining down the block just to watch what I got. So delicious. It's hot, hot, so delicious. I put them boys on rock, rock, so delicious. They want a taste of what I got, so delicious. Taste it.
Burgalicious, dip. Burgalicious, dip. Burgalicious, dip. Burgalicious definition, make them boys go crazy.
If you are interested, don't forget to pick up a cheer packet in room 5108 from Miss Sergi. She hopes to see as many as possible out there.
Book club will be meeting tomorrow, Wednesday, March 20th, during second lunch in room 326. They will also be meeting next Tuesday, March 26th, during second lunch in room 326.
We are a little less than 2 months away from prom. Prom will be on Saturday, May 11th. The theme for prom this year will be Memories Under the Moonlight. The location for this event will be at the luxurious Coro de Casa Golf Course Golf Club down in South Orange County. The price for one prom ticket is $85 and $80 with an ASB card. So now is a good time to start planning on purchasing your tickets and finding that date of yours.
Before it's late.
Yeah.
They take her. And Grad Bash, which is only 2 months away, taking place on Thursday, May 30th at Universal Studios. The starting price for those tickets is still $95, and if you have an ASB card, you guys know you guys are in luck. You'll be saving $10 off of that Grad Bash ticket. What a better way to spend the last time out being with your high school friends than at a theme park. Cascade, who was voted the best voted DJ, will be hosting Grad Night for that day. Bus transportation will be included, and the same goes for the last day to purchase your Grad Bash tickets is this Friday before 3 p.m. So you'll have to purchase it before the day ends.
You gotta act quick, you know, before Friday. And if you guys don't have any plans for the weekend, well, on Saturday, March 23rd at East End in downtown Santa Ana at the intersection of Bush Street and 3rd, will come the greatest Patches and Pins Expo. Starting at 12 o'clock noon and until 7 p.m., you will be able to buy, sell, or trade patches and pins.
All ages are welcome and admission is free, although you do need to get your tickets at eventbrite.com. Here's a quick video from the past expo held in downtown Santa Ana.
Marcos, you know what's been on my mind lately?
Tell me, what is it?
If your leg gets cut off, would it hurt?
Of course it would hurt.
How though?
Because your leg gets cut off, fool.
Where would you feel the pain?
In your leg.
How are you going to feel the pain in your leg if your leg is gone?
If your leg is gone.
I'm telling you, bro, this is crazy.
So exactly, where would you feel the pain?
That's the point. There's no pain, G. Once your leg gone, the pain goes with it.
Makes sense.
Well, I'm telling you, fool, we're smart as hell. Well, with that being said, that is all the news we have for you today. But remember, Centurions,
where would the pain go? Mistakes are vital for success.
As long as you learn from them.
Bye.
Yeah, so there's no pain, G.
The pain.